What is up, YouTube? We are here in, do you remember the name?
Mineral de something.
Mineral de Pozos, which is also a pueblo mágico, magical town here in Mexico. And it has been a little bit of
odyssey.
A little bit of a struggle, yeah, to the Greek guy would say it was an odyssey. it's been a little challenging to actually get to this little town. We were in San Miguel de Allende. I really, really wanted to come here. It was almost like on my top list of things to do, so we made it happen. Uh-huh. But now we're in this Jardín Juárez, which is the central plaza here in Mineral de Pozos. And one of the things that surprised me and Pete was there isn't a lot of people.
No.
Even Pete was like, is it?
They closed the town for the winter.
He hasn't even closed the town. I'm like, I don't know how you close a town. I
mean, they're all in common.
We're a little surprised. This little jardín is actually really...
it's cute.
It's really, like, yeah, because it's small. It's not like a really big one, but it's very well, looks like very well maintained.
Yeah.
They set the Christmas tree up, and behind us you can see the arches. The arches that you see in a lot of these towns here in Mexico. I really like the stonework that they have. It's a mining town, guys, as a lot of the towns have been, but we're gonna find those elements that make this place particularly beautiful.
Yeah.
Ready to go, Pete?
Yeah, come along.
Let's go. All right, everyone, so we are in another location here in Mineral de Pozos. And in this plaza, there's a church behind me that's abandoned, and also another one that's like semi-destroyed behind me. We can't seem to get into there because they have a fence around them, but I'm gonna try my best to give you guys a picture of what it looks like, because they're just these really old structures. You can tell how old this town is. I want to give you guys a quick look. These original walls, or these adobe walls, are basically the ones that are made out of mud. Unfortunately, these churches are only open on the weekends, so we're not gonna be able to see them today, but I was hoping to get a couple shots to show you guys at least what they look like. This one behind me, you may be able to see a little bit of it, is ruined. We're gonna go try to see some of the mines. Hopefully they're open, because I've been told we can actually go into the mine and see how the workers used to work them. So let's keep going. How far out of town this is? Like 15 minutes?
15 minutes.
Yeah, and we weren't moving fast because the roads are unpaved. They're just dirt roads.
What you see here is what you get.
This area was built in around 1590. So we're talking, you know, 400 years ago that they built this. And the Jesuits, I guess, actually ran this area. Here, they actually melted a lot of the gold and silver that they found in the mines.
I don't know, I like these abandoned buildings because you kind of are looking at ruins.
Yeah.
And you're kind of seeing nature take over again. Like, look, these are obviously something right here. Look, they're filled with water.
Is that one filled with water, Pete?
This one's filled with water. Some sort of green water.
Oh, wow. We are the only ones here. Really, it only gets busy during the weekends. I don't know, I kind of think that's great to show you guys around without a bunch of people getting in the way.
Well, that was a big dragonfly. Wow.
Oh, is it just a big,
A big old hole.
Holy moly, it just keeps getting bigger and bigger.
It kind of gets intimidating as you get closer.
Yeah, as you get closer. I don't even want to get that close. Pete is way closer than me. Yeah, I mean, it is the dry season, so this may have water during the, does rain a lot here in Guanajuato, but once the rain's gone, it's all gone. And that's why a lot of times there's a lot of dams in Guanajuato, because people that need water for agriculture or things like this, they needed to dam the water up.
So when is the dry season?
Well, it certainly doesn't feel like winter, does it?
No, it doesn't.
It's probably, it's a great temperature actually. It's like, probably like 75 degrees. So we made it to the Jesuit ovens. This is where they would melt the actual gold and silver down. Unfortunately, it's fenced off. You can't touch it. You can't
go into it. Can't go around. Can't even go around it. We can't even see the back of it.
Yeah. So the only reason I can think so is because I see there's an open pit behind it. Mm-hmm. It may be a safety reason, but. I don't know.
Preservation, maybe. They don't want tourists messing around with it.
It's true. There could be a lot of those reasons. So it's okay. We're going to show you the best we can. These impressive structures that you see in a lot of the pictures when you Google Mineral de Pozos. And there's still a lot more to see. You know, we were wondering, or Pete was wondering, like, how... We don't know enough about the mining process. Like, how does the gold separate? How does the silver separate? How does the fire play a role into it? If you know, leave a comment below. Any miners watching my channel? I know, I said no miner jokes. Just like the other hacienda, you need to be very careful about where you step. You don't never know what's gonna be under a rock or anything like that. But I'm just gonna give you guys a quick look at the inside of here. Wow, the fact that we can walk through here is kind of incredible. I was telling Pete, these walls, they're massive. They probably needed to be used to defend against people wanting to raid this place. Unbelievable. One of the things that was curious that I never seen is the guy was talking about these magic arcs. Here it says magic arcs of the sun and the moon. And apparently it was used for astronomical purposes. I have no idea what's inside, guys. It looks very interesting. Oh, the other thing he said it was used for was for cooling of the mines. So like maybe it was an airflow, a way to get airflow into the mines, right? Because if you think about it, the mines were up to 200 meters deep, and this is January, and it is hot under the sun. So if you imagine this in the summer, would have been unbearable. Yeah. All right, let's go through this. Oh my God, look at that. Whoa, it just goes. That is totally unexpected. Pete, could you feel the breeze?
That's
when we came
very
in? Can you, like, as we were walking in through the door, this created like a little corridor of air. That's, I don't know, it's kind of surreal. I can't express you guys, you know, the last time I saw something like this was in Cambodia in one of the temples. And it's just like, it's perfectly aligned.
And it goes on forever.
Let's go check it out. I'm super stoked. Whoa, look at that. Whoa. It just.
Don't go through that.
No, I'm not getting in, but is that water? Oh no, that's a hole.
No, that's a hole.
It's
and
a
it
hole.
It continues onto another wall.
It's a hole on the other side. Yeah, you're right. Let's keep going. I'm almost more impressed with this than the ovens, but the ovens are what people like come to take pictures in front of. And it still looks super far away. I don't even know how far away it is.
Hey, it doesn't even feel like we're halfway done with this tunnel.
All right guys, we're coming up to the end, the last column. I'm not sure if there's anything here to see, or it may just end. Okay, so,
that's where the air comes in from. So you know what happens? So you know how chimneys work? Have you ever like turned on your chimney at home And then the fire, it's really warm in front of the fire, but then you go to the other side of the house and it's freezing.
Yeah.
Because the heat gets pulled up through.
Mm.
So what this is doing is probably pulling in air from over there, and all the hot air is coming in here, so that's why it's cool over on that end.
Just showing us that this is still an adobe wall. You can see the little bits of hay and stone and mud that it was made up of. Look, there's the original adobe wall there. You guys can see it's half ruined at this point, but it's a nice reminder of what this place used to be, because this would the one behind us would be considered a modern structure compared to the adobe bricks. So Pete, what are we doing after we see the hacienda?
Getting a nice refreshing pulque.
Uh-huh.
And enchiladas mineros.
Enchiladas mineros, okay. Pete's getting hungry. Very good, Pete. I'm getting hungry, Pete's getting hungry. We're gonna go see the center of the town where the little jardin was, where we started the video. It was actually very, very quaint, very cute, very nice. And quiet, yeah. And it was like, if you wanted to spend a whole day reading a book and having like a coffee,
or it'd michelada. Be like,
or michelada if you're Pete, then that would be almost like the perfect place to do it. So I'm getting hungry and hoping that there's something delicious in town so we can go check it out.
This is pretty famous in multiple aspects. Antonio Banderas and Pancho Villa, and multiple, I would assume, Mexican movies.
All right, Pete, we're back in the center of town. This is where we started our trip, and the hunger has set in.
Yeah.
Yeah. Like he's actually super, super patient. He's not like hangry. Not yet. Right? Let's go see if we can find, I'm not sure if we're gonna find exactly that food that Pete was looking for, but we'll see what we can do. ¿Y las enchiladas mineras, Pete?
No. Maybe next time.
Oh, all right, Pete. No enchiladas mineras, no pulque. But maybe we can find it back in when we get back to San Miguel de Allende.
Or Guanajuato.
Yeah. So look, this day started off kind of slow, but it really picked up steam and we found some really interesting things, huh?
Yeah, I had fun.
Yeah, it was really interesting. I highly recommend coming to Mineral de Pozos. If you have any questions about coming here, leave me a comment down below. But I hope you guys do visit because it's kind of an incredible place. All right, Pete, what do we need to tell the people on YouTube?
Tell the people on YouTube to like, subscribe, share.
All right, see you guys. Bye-bye.